Good morning, everyone, and welcome to online worship with Holy Trinity Lutheran Church based in New Prague, Minnesota. We are so glad to have you with us this morning. With all the different distractions we have in our modern day, it can be so easy to skip worship and choose to spend your time on something else. So we appreciate you for choosing to prioritize God this morning and recognize how that's not always easy. We hope you are able to take this time to really let yourself connect with God and those in our church community this morning, even if you're worshiping online. Pastor Alicia will be leading us in worship this morning as we continue our Lenten journey. We are looking at the story of the prodigal son and exploring how might we find ourselves in this story. Again, thank you for being here with us this morning. Let us begin worship in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
A reading from Luke, the 15th chapter. Now all the tax collectors and sinners were coming near to listen to him, and the Pharisees and the scribes were grumbling and saying, "This fellow welcomes sinners and eats well with them." So he told them in this parable, "There was a man who had two sons. The younger of them said to his father, 'Father, give me the share of your property that will belong to me.' So he divided his property between them. A few days later, the younger son gathered all that he had and traveled to a distant country, and there he squandered his property in dissolute living. When he had spent everything, and a severe famine took place throughout the country, and he began to be in need. So he went and hired himself out to one of the citizens of that country, who sent him to his fields to feed the pigs. He would gladly have filled himself with the pods that the pigs were eating, and no one gave him anything. But when he came to himself and said, 'How many of my father's hired hands have you bread enough to spare? I am here dying of hunger. I will get up and go to my father, and you will say to him, Father, I have sinned against heaven and before you. I am no longer worthy to be called your son. Treat me like one of your hired hands.' So he set off and went to his father. But while he was still far off, his father saw him and was filled with compassion. He ran out and put his arms around him and kissed him. Then the son said to him, 'Father, I have sinned against heaven and before you. I am no longer worthy to be called your son.' But the father said to his slaves, 'Quickly bring out a robe, the best one, and put it on him. Put a ring on his finger and sandals on his feet, and get the flatted calf and kill it, and let us eat and celebrate. For this is the son of mine, was dead and is alive again. He was lost and is found.' And they began to celebrate. Now his elder son was in the field, and when he came and approached the house, he heard music and dancing. He called out one of the slaves and asked what was going on. He replied, 'Your brother has come, and your father has killed the flatted calf because he got him back safe and sound.' Then he became angry and refused to go in. His father came out and began to plead with him. But he answered his father, 'Listen, for all these years I have been working like a slave for you. I have never disobeyed your command, yet you have never given me even a young goat so that I may celebrate with my friends. But when this son of yours came back, who has devoured your property with prostitutes and killed the flattest calf for him,' then his father said to him, 'Son, you are always with me, and all that is mine is yours. But we had to celebrate and rejoice because your brother of yours was dead and has come to life. He was lost and has been found.' The word of the Lord."
You know, over the course of Lent, we are looking at gospel stories in terms of the theme of full to the brim. And today's parable that we're talking about is likely one you've heard before, likely one that's a bit familiar. You've probably heard it from a few different lenses, maybe. And if you're like me, at times you can relate to different characters in this story. Sometimes I can relate to the older sibling, sometimes I can relate to the younger one. Well, there have been times, as I think about that, when I've been like the younger sibling and I've squandered that which has been entrusted to me, and there are times I can relate to the older sibling who's jealous of others receiving forgiveness or attention. Well, after the past 2 years, I don't think we are lacking at all in an ability to apply this story to our lives and look at it. And oftentimes we compare, when we look at this parable, the younger sibling and the older sibling. We often look at the older being the responsible and hardworking one and the younger being the lavish, unfaithful, irresponsible one. But today I want to look at it a little differently. I wonder if today we can look at the responses and the actions, not of the younger and the older sibling, but of the older brother and the father. Well, my first question for you is, over the last 2 years, where have you felt like the older sibling in this story? Where have you experienced maybe some growing resentment from fielding just a huge amount of responsibility while watching others not feel the same weight? I wonder if we imagine some of these scenarios, if you might be able to relate to the older sibling today. Let's start with the pandemic. In terms of the pandemic, maybe you felt like, or have felt like over the last 2 years, you've borne the weight of responsibility, while others haven't felt that same weight. Maybe in your personal life or professional life, you've followed the public health guidelines only to be mocked by others. Or maybe you've been on the front lines serving, facing threats head on every day, and felt unappreciated. Well, if you can relate to any of these things, you can relate to the older brother. Or let's think about it in terms of the workforce. Maybe you have growing resentment because you're working your tail off. Maybe you're understaffed at your workplace and you're having to fill in with double shifts or covering other responsibilities. Maybe it's hard to find people to work and you've had a now hiring sign in your window for months. Maybe you're wondering, when will I be compensated for all this extra work and stress I've been carrying? Well, if you can relate to this, you can relate to the older brother. Or maybe in terms of racial justice work. Maybe you feel some sense of bitterness because you've been trying hard to become more self-aware, work on becoming anti-racist, only to be aware of others not doing the work around you. Maybe you feel critiqued and evaluated. Maybe you're the one to apologize, to offer public statements. And yet again, you may feel like you are the one to step up and say something. Well, if you can relate to any of these things, you can relate to the older brother. Or let's think about it in terms of family. Maybe you're the person in your family who's a saver, a budgeter, a hard worker, and yet you see others in your family who are able to freely spend, to go on vacations, use money to find enjoyment. Maybe they don't feel that same weight of financial responsibility for the future. Maybe they feel like someone will bail them out. Maybe they're not worried about saving because of that. Well, if you can relate to any of these things, you can relate to the older brother. Or maybe let's look at it a different way. Maybe you're the one responsible for caregiving in your family. You're the one who maybe gave up some professional aspirations because someone needed caring for. All the while, maybe you have other siblings or a sibling who didn't feel that same weight for care. Maybe they don't send the regular emails, make the regular phone calls. They don't feel the same responsibility for appointments and errands and conference and care calls. Maybe you're left to feel that weight. If you can relate to these things, you can relate to the older brother. All right, one last scenario, the church. Whenever Jamie needs a volunteer, maybe she calls on you. Because when there's a need, you step up. You said yes over and over and over again because you feel like it's the right thing to do, but you're tired and growing resentment, wondering, how do those people get out of this? Why do they never have to help? Well, if you feel these things, once again, you can relate to the older brother. Being the hard worker, the responsible one, the budgeter, the one loyal to family, the one who follows the rules and gets mocked for it, the one who apologizes for others, the volunteer extraordinaire. You can relate to the older brother. Well, it's no wonder that the younger brother took the inheritance early, left home, leaving the older brother to work double shifts, take on the responsibility and the weight, and then only to return home empty-handed and given a big party. No wonder you're upset or feeling resentment. There's no way around it. It's just not fair. The younger brother should repent, apologize, give back, and repay the money with interest. Today, if you resonate with the older brother, my guess is you're in good company. In some ways, maybe you do wish God actually did keep score, because you might feel like you have a lot to show. You've given a lot, done a lot, tried a lot. But the truth is today, the older brother's not in a healthy place. In the language of our Lenten theme, the older brother is full to the brim with bitterness and resentment and jealousy, anger. While the older brother's followed the rules, been loyal, trustworthy, carried the fair share of the responsibility, his spirit is empty. His joy is gone. His heart is hollow. I think God wants more for him than that. You know, like I said earlier, my hope today is not that we compare the older and the younger brother, but instead that we compare the older brother and the father. Because instead of welcoming the younger brother home with resentment and jealousy and anger and frustration and bitterness, the father leaves all judgment at the front porch step and runs down the driveway to embrace his son. Well, I have to be honest, when I think about those in my own life who are the most full to the brim with God's love, it's my elders. I think of the times when I felt negative about myself or circumstances, whether there are things I've done or haven't done, haven't measured up. It's the elders in my life who've given me a dose of unconditional love. It's the elders in my life that have reminded me what life's all about. It's the elders in my life who've had their priorities in the right order. They might share a nugget of wisdom, but it's in the context of a sincere smile and a warm embrace. They've seen it all, and it brings them happiness, more happiness than anything else, to see their loved ones home. You know, when I picture this story myself, I can't help but picture the people in my own life. And when I hear this story about the elder running down the driveway to embrace their son, for me, what I picture an elder in my life opening the door with one hand and having one hand on a walker. I picture an elder in my life walking down the road again, arms on that walker, and then stopping when we meet and putting arms out to embrace. You know, in our lives, sometimes I think subconsciously we think about God as the older brother. Quick to punish with resentment, keeping score, angry, jealous, judging. But today Jesus tells us that God doesn't see us like the older brother. He sees us like the wise elder, the father, not only ready but running to embrace and show love and welcome home. You know, this God also gives us an opportunity to decide what we want our full to the brim lives to look like. He gives us a choice. Do we want our lives to be full of frustration, resentment, anger, bitterness, like the older brother? Or instead, Do we want to be full to the brim with joy and grace, forgiveness, and love? You see, the older brother might be wealthy, but he's not wise. He might have money, but he's not mature. He might have loyalty to his family, but he doesn't have love. This father, a generation older, has learned something that his son needs to learn. The material wealth doesn't lead to relational, emotional, or spiritual health. The father in this parable of the prodigal son shows us what a full to the brim life, full to the brim of God's spirit and life looks like. And I pray today that our lives might be full to the brim like that too. Amen. Now we go to share God's love for all people from one generation to the next. And as we do, may we remember God goes with us. God goes before us to show us the way, behind us to encourage us, beside us to befriend us, above us watching over us, and within us to give us peace. In the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen.
Hey everyone, my name is Karen and I'm here with your weekly rundown for Holy Trinity Lutheran Church. This week, our radio ministry is sponsored by Joan Bonsack. Thank you so much for this gift of ministry. Well, in a few weeks, we're gearing up for Easter and we are having services at 8:30 and 10 a.m. In between, we are having this great opportunity for a family photo shoot. Gina Fadden, our resident graphic designer and photographer, will be setting up a great photo shoot in the Fellowship Hall. Now again, the theme is He is Risen. So I invite you to come dressed in your Sunday best and have a great photo of your family to commemorate Easter 2022. Thanks so much to Gina for setting up this great event for our church community. A reminder that we are in the last few weeks of our March food drive. We are filling the little pantry to the brim. And I remind you to bring your breakfast items of granola bars, breakfast bars, and juice boxes to the church during worship services. There's going to be a grocery cart where you can drop off your items. And then when the warmer months hit, we will be using those items to fill the pantry. Thank you so much for your generosity. A reminder that we are signing up for VBS this summer. We are in coordination with Cristo Obrero Church and Prairie Oaks Institute for a bilingual nature-based VBS experience. It's happening August 1st and it's open for children all the way, ages from pre-K all the way up to fifth grade. Now, if you have a middle school or a high schooler, they are welcome to sign up to be a volunteer. It's going to be a great summer for VBS. Lastly, I'd like to remind you of all of the sign-up opportunities that we have at Holy Trinity. I invite you to go to our website, holytrinityonline.org. On our main page, you will see a button that says Sign Up. There you will, if you click that button, you'll go to the Sign Up Genius and you will find sign up links to the New Life Strategic 2.0 huddle that's happening on April 3rd. You can sign up there to RSVP and save your seat. You can also sign up to volunteer, not only as a worship assistant, but for that New Life huddle to help set up, provide childcare, be a food server, or help clean up. Thanks so much for joining us. Enjoy your day. I got an old church choir singing in my soul. I got a sweet salvation and it's beautiful. I've got a heart overflowing, it's been restored. There ain't nothing gonna steal my joy. No, there ain't nothing gonna steal my joy. Oh, there ain't nothing gonna steal my joy.